Mike Chibita has tipped law students to always stick to the facts as well as observe the highest ethical standards if they are to become better lawyers in future. Cavendish University emerged the winners of the 10th annual Inter-University Constitutional Moot Court Competition. They defeated the Pentecostal University of Kampala campus in the final round, and initially 11 universities that offer the law course participated in this year's competitions, including Makerere University, Uganda Christian University, Nkumba University, among others. The contestants were assessed by a panel of judges, which was led by the Supreme Court Justice Mike Chibita, who later handed over a trophy and certificates to the winners.
Congratulations.
He commended the contestants and advised them to always be very audible and confident while arguing their cases in court.
When you've made your case, sit down. As Justice Ogola told me, when you get up, stand up, speak up, and then shut up. I will go to the Beijing rules. You know, you have to know persuasive versus binding, and you cannot keep hammering persuasive.
These students were further tipped on being better lawyers, especially once they stick to facts and being ethical.
Be as natural as possible, to emphasize what the lady justice said, use as simple language as possible. It's not impressive to use complicated sentences, because all we are interested in is how do you deliver what you want to say?
You need to improve on a few things. First of all, we gave you a lot of time. Nobody gives you 30 minutes before the courts, especially the Court of Appeal and Supreme Court. They'll probably give you most 10 or 15. So you must be very well prepared with just what you need to say. I could see eventually you had said it all, but because you had a lot of time, and that really irritates the bench.
The problem that the law students debated on was advancing reproductive health and gender justice in the country, all intended to interest them to take up issues of health and defend them in court once they become lawyers.
The justice in Uganda, based on the case scenarios that affect young women and girls in schools, teenage pregnancies, dropping out of schools, sexual violence, being defiled by their parents, by their teachers, and then they stop living meaningful lives. So we are looking at how can a scenario in court give direction that, you know, government, you have a duty to look at these girls that are suffering down there due to sexual violence, due to defilement. How can they live meaningful lives?
The winners of the competition said they have learned a lot about health issues, thus making the commitment to always ensure justice for health matters.
And also getting the opportunity to represent the rights of the girl child, being a fellow girl, and also getting to know the challenges that these other girls experience, and being able to air out their views, and us winning as the appellants representing their case was something that overjoyed me. And we, the girls, we really need to know more about sexuality education.
Very wonderful experience. We have gained litigation experience, and we know this is going to help us in our search skills and even our further experience in the law. I'm so grateful. It has not been easy. We have had sleepless nights, but above all, we had trust in the Almighty God, and this is how far we have made.
The Center for Health, Human Rights and Development organizes moot court competitions annually to acquaint the law students with issues of health and the right to advance social justice. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.